Hi, and welcome back to Tech Talk. I'm Ken Mingis, Executive Editor at Computerworld. I'm here with CSO's Lucian Constantin to talk about a big SAP exploit that could get a lot of companies in trouble. Stick around. So, Lucian, thanks for being here. I know it's later in the day in the Romanian bureau there, and so I appreciate you taking a few minutes to talk about this SAP exploit. We were talking a little bit a minute ago that I guess it's known as 10K Blaze, although we're not quite sure where that name came from. But what is it? What can it do? And why should companies be concerned about it?
Sure. Thanks for having me, and it's always a pleasure to talk to you. So these exploits, they're not a technical vulnerability in the sense that they're not a code bug. They are misconfigurations or insecure default configurations that have been known for a decade now. And they are in two components of SAP environments or SAP deployments called the SAP Gateway and the SAP Message Server. SAP has known about this for a long time, and there have been several alerts issued over the years with guidance on how to mitigate these problems. And then later, security researchers came up with some variations where they can bypass, and SAP came with other guidance and things like that. The problem is that it's very hard to patch SAP or to change some configuration in SAP deployments because of all the historical burden, because many enterprises do a lot of customizations to these systems. Researchers from Onapsis estimate that on average companies add 2 million lines of code to their SAP deployments. So changing a setting, an important setting like that, could obviously lead to incompatibilities with those customizations. It can break stuff, can cause downtime, and these are business critical applications, and no one can afford to have significant downtime with them because that means incurring losses. And these components are critical for a lot of SAP applications like S/4HANA, ERP, enterprise resource planning, product lifecycle management, customer relationship management, CRM, human capital management, supply chain management, supplier relationship management, basically, and a few others, all that use NetWeaver Business Warehouse, NetWeaver ABAP application server, any application that uses that component. So this affects a lot of, can impact a lot of applications. That not necessarily depends on configuration, but Onapsis estimates that 1 in 10 SAP systems deployed by more than 50,000 SAP customers worldwide from its customer base of 400,000 are vulnerable to this. So.
Yeah, I'm glad you pointed that. Yeah, actually, the way I was looking at it, this is, from you've written about this earlier this month, and I read it as saying that potentially 9 out of 10, is that what you were saying, 9 out of 10 systems could be potentially vulnerable, SAP systems?
So they estimate that around 50,000 customers out of 400,000 have one of these potentially affected applications.
Okay.
And of those that have one of these potentially affected applications, 9 out of 10 of their systems is affected.
Got it.
Right? So okay. A subset of customers, and 9 out of 10 of those customers.
It surprises me I'm sorry, go ahead.
Yeah, because I mean, like a SAP deployment, SAP deployment involves multiple systems, obviously. It's not having one system per enterprise. These are talking about tens of systems across a large enterprise or hundreds of systems.
Yeah, what I was going to say is it surprises me that, this is obviously a configuration issue. This is not completely out of the blue. I mean, this, this vulnerability that's now being exploited has been there, And I'm just sort of surprised that either companies haven't gotten the message yet and figured out that they need to close this or configure these systems in a way that they're less vulnerable to this, or that SAP hasn't been able to do something to sort of, you know, close off these attack vectors. Do we see that? Is there something that companies are missing here, or that SAP is missing that might, you know, help avoid future problems for companies that have their software?
Not necessarily. It's about the so one of the configuration issues can be changed and patched pretty easily. For the other one, it's a more involved process. Onapsis estimates that it's a process that can take up to a year for a large enterprise, because it involves modifying other systems and other things. So companies, even if they knew about these issues, they've been putting them off because of the complexity of making such a change across their entire system. The danger now is that while these vulnerabilities or misconfigurations had been known for a while, now there are exploits publicly available because some researchers released them at a conference and they are now on GitHub, and which makes them accessible to obviously a larger number of attackers, and even unskilled attackers, because up until this point, attacks against ERP systems, so business systems that contain critical business data, was more of a nation state type of cyber espionage attack, right?
Right.
But now, since these exploits are very easy to use, they are just required to have like Python installed, and it's point and click if the server is available on the internet, it's very easy to exploit. Now, basically, any kid can do it, right? Any hacktivist who's upset about something a company did, any ransomware type of attack can destroy or delete data. And obviously, also the more sophisticated attacks, which could mean manipulating the data inside. So you could use this to force the company to file false reports to the securities agencies and then impact their stock price, right? So you can, if you do it right, you can actually manipulate the stock price because you know in advance that it will come out and you can benefit from it, right?
So isn't that one of the reasons we were thinking that it's called 10K Blaze, because it would allow hacktivists to somehow, you know, manipulate the data in a company's 10K filing, which, as you say, if they know that they're doing this, that this is going to come out, that the data that a company's reporting is now wrong, you know, that could certainly affect a company's bottom line and their stock price, and you know, just cause a lot of turmoil for the company and even in, you know, the larger markets there, if these activists get very smart and targeted at what they're doing.
Right, exactly. So what companies should do about this is they have to start. I mean, that's the whole point of this alert, and the US CERT alert and the Onapsis alert, is that these exploits are now out there. The risk is now higher of attacks targeting these systems occurring. And companies should start doing it, because it's going to take some time. So it's not going to be an overnight fix. So they should get their SAP service provider together with the cybersecurity vendor, and ask them to figure it out. So first they should deploy monitoring capabilities. Another problem with this is that not many network firewalls or network scanners and things like that, monitoring tools, had detections for SAP exploits or SAP attacks or ERP attacks in general, because while this particular vulnerability is for ASP deployments, from my experience, Oracle ERP applications are not free of vulnerabilities either. I mean, you just have to look at their quarterly patches and you'll see highly critical vulnerabilities every single patch cycle. So these types of attacks might start targeting this type of systems in general. So you need monitoring for this type of exploits. That's why Onapsis released this detection signatures for these particular vulnerabilities or attacks. for the SNORT, which is an open source intrusion detection system, network-based intrusion detection system. So now anyone, I mean, they don't have to necessarily have a paid product. If they use SNORT, which is open source, they can just download these definitions. They're freely available. They can monitor their networks to see if there are any attacks going on. And obviously start working on changing the configurations and doing all that's needed to fix this. And it's going to take some time.
Yeah, I think
depends on how large their deployment is.
Right, and how complex it is and how they may have modified it. Yeah, it does seem like the most important point here is that companies have to start on this like yesterday, because you know this exploit's out there. It's now being spread around among, you know, many more potential hackers and hacktivists than would have had access to it in the past. Monitoring is an issue, and because it takes such a long time to change the configurations and figure out where the vulnerability is, this is not something that a company should be waiting on, right?
Right, because there has been a report out last year where of signs of attackers actually targeting this system. So they've noticed campaigns by hacktivists, by nation states, and a lot of talk on the underground forums about SAP exploits or ARP exploits in general. So clearly both cyber criminals and more sophisticated actors have an interest in targeting such systems. So these attacks are likely to come at some point. They might not be a very high level of attacks against ARP systems now, but with these exploits out there, and with the interest shown by attackers, they will start to rise in numbers. And honestly, we don't even know, because if you don't have monitoring capabilities as a company, you might not even know that your system has been compromised, and it could go unnoticed for years. I mean, like malware infections go unnoticed for hundreds of days sometimes, based on reports. Imagine something like this, it could go unnoticed for years. So if there's no public reporting about such compromises, we don't really know how many attacks have actually happened so far.
Yeah, I was just going to say the sort of scary point is that there may have already been attacks that companies are not aware of. So this is a very cautionary tale. And I think, you know, you make the point that being forewarned is forearmed. If you've got an SAP system that's vulnerable to 10K blaze, you better be on top of that now. And you should be looking for monitoring tools that can check and see if you've already been hacked and maybe data changed or, data that's been breached. Obviously, we'll keep an eye on that. I know you will, and monitor this stuff to see if public attacks become obvious. I think for now, though, that's a lot of information that I think companies need to know, and I appreciate the insights.
Sure, always happy to talk to you and share my my knowledge about this type of things.
No, I think it's important. I really do. You know, you do have an understanding of this, and I think that's why this is an important message for companies with SAP deployments. Lucian, I will let you go. Again, like I say, I know it's late in the day there. Thanks for the update, and we'll circle back with you later on during the year and try to track down and see if this is how this is going, whether it's getting worse or not.
Sure.
Okay. Thanks
Sounds
a lot.
Good. Thank you.
Okay. Thanks a lot.
Thanks for having me.
Thank you. As a reminder, you can subscribe to our channel if you like what you're seeing here on Tech Talk. For now, that's it for me, Ken Mingis, and Lucian. That's a wrap.